Hi everyone, it's the Math Sorcerer here with Chegg. In this video, we're going to be discussing factoring polynomials. Part A, we have 2x squared minus 18. Let's work through it, solution. Whenever you're thinking about factoring a polynomial, you always want to start by seeing if there's a common factor. In this case, both terms, 2x squared and negative 18, have a common factor of 2. You can write this as 2, parentheses, and then you ask yourself, what do you multiply by 2 in order to get 2x squared? Well, just x squared. And then you ask, what do you multiply by 2 to get negative 18? Well, negative 9. Then you should always check mentally. 2 times x squared is 2x squared. 2 times negative 9 is negative 18. Here we have a really good situation. X squared minus 9 is the difference of squares. This ends up becoming x minus 3 times x plus 3, and that would be the answer to part A. So the formula we used for the x squared minus 9 is the one that says if you have a squared minus b squared, it's equal to a minus b times a plus b. It's called the difference of squares formula. In our particular example here, we had x squared minus 9, which is really x squared minus 3 squared, and so that's x minus 3 times x plus 3. Okay, let's go ahead and do another example. Part B, we have x squared plus 3x plus 2. Let's go ahead and try to factor this solution. So because we have a 1 here in front of the x squared, and there's no common factors, we're going to try to factor this by guessing. So basically, you write two parentheses like this, and you have an x here, and you have an x here. You have a number here besides 1. You can still use guessing, but it's a little bit harder. Now we need two numbers that multiply to 2 and add to 3. Well, that's pretty simple. It's just going to be 1 and 2, and they're both positive. You should always check. I'm going to show you a trick that will allow you to check very quickly. I'm going to use a different color. So you can look at x times x, that's x squared, that part's easy. And then 1 times 2 is 2, that part's easy. The hard part is the 3x. Well, the inner piece is x, because 1 times x is x, and the outer piece is 2x. If you add the inner and the outer, you always get the middle term. It's really, really cool. You see that? 2x plus x is 3x. Anyways, the answer to this one is x plus 1 times x plus 2. Let's do a harder example. Part C, we have x cubed plus x squared minus x minus 1. Let's go ahead and try to factor solution. Whenever you have four terms, you should automatically, immediately think about something called factor by grouping. You want to look at these terms here, and you want to look at these terms here to see if there's a common factor. So looking at the first set of terms, x cubed plus x squared, we can see we can pull out an x squared. When we do that, we get x squared parentheses x plus 1. And you can check, x squared times x is x cubed, x squared times 1 is x squared. Now we want to factor something out from minus x minus 1 that we're left with an x plus 1. That something else is going to be a minus 1. And watch this, parentheses, x plus 1. And you can check, minus 1 times x is minus x, minus 1 times positive 1 is minus 1. So we pulled out an x squared from the first two terms, we pulled out a minus 1 from the last two terms, and that forced us to have a common factor of x plus 1. So now we can pull out the x plus 1 and put it in the front. And we're left with x squared minus 1. And we're not done, right? X squared minus 1 is really the difference of squares. This is x plus 1, x minus 1, x plus 1. Using that difference of squares formula we saw earlier, because it's really x squared minus 1 squared, which is x minus 1 times x plus 1. So that would be the factorization in part C. This method is called factor by grouping. Let's go ahead and finish up with a much harder example. Part D, we have 2x squared minus 5x plus 2. Let's try to factor this solution. So because we have a 2 in front of the x squared, factor by guessing might be a little bit too challenging. So let's try a different method. This method I'm going to show you is very powerful. The first step is to take the coefficient of x squared, which is 2, and multiply it by the constant term, which is 2. You take these two numbers and multiply them. So 2 times 2 is equal to 4. And then I like to write down what we need because it makes it easier to think about. So we need two numbers that multiply to 4, right? So you multiply these two, we get 4. That means we need two numbers that multiply to 4, and they also have to add to the coefficient of x, which in this case is negative 5, so the number here in front of the x. So again, you multiply these two numbers, you get an answer, we get 4. Then you have to find two numbers that multiply to 4, but also add to negative 5. So those numbers are going to be negative 4 and negative 1, and that's because negative 4 times negative 1 is positive 4, and if you add negative 4 and negative 1, you get negative 5. All right, so now we're going to factor. Watch this. So we have 2x squared minus 5x plus 2. And so what you want to do now is you want to use these numbers to break up the middle term, negative 5x, because you know it adds to those. You know that these numbers add to negative 5. You can write it as 2x squared minus 4x minus 1 times x plus 2. So we've basically taken the negative 5x and we've broken it up into negative 4x minus 1x. Really powerful. And now we'll factor by grouping. So we'll pull out a 2x here. That'll leave us with x minus 2. And just like before, we want to have an x minus 2 over here. So we'll pull out that minus 1, and that'll leave us with x minus 2. Beautiful. Here we have x minus 2. Here we have x minus 2. So you can pull out the x minus 2. So x minus 2. And we have 2x minus 1. And that would be the factored answer. Very, very nice, very powerful technique because it requires no guessing. So just to recap, whenever you have something like this where you can't really factor it by guessing, and it seems like you can't really apply any formulas, you take the number in front of the x squared in the constant term, you multiply them and you get an answer. Then you need two numbers that multiply to this number, in this case 4, but add to the middle term, so negative 5. We found those numbers, negative 4 and negative 1. Then you rewrite it and you break up that middle term using those numbers, and then you just use factor by grouping and go from there. Very powerful method. Hopefully you've learned some math watching this video, and if you've enjoyed this video, make sure to check out more videos on Chegg. Until next time, good luck, take care.